So for today, we will be discussing lens defects. This is Module 5, Lesson 2. So from the name itself, pag sinabing lens defects, may problema o mga problema sa lente natin. So sabi dito, no lens is perfect in every respect. So walang isang lens na meron ang lahat, na meron siyang lahat. Okay? Usually, lens makers try to find the best compromise among such qualities as sharpness of definition, speed of light transmission, simplicity of construction, and others. Special purpose lenses are computed for a single purpose only, and in order to achieve the maximum usefulness in one special field, other qualities are sacrificed. So again, walang isang lens na taglay niya lahat ng katangian na pwedeng magkaroon ang isang lente. Kumbaga, sa isang lens, kapag binigyan natin siya ng isang quality, may ibang quality naman na nako-compromise or nasa sacrifice. Kumbaga, parang sabihin na natin, kalahati ng katangian niya perfect, then may iba pa siyang katangian na hindi masyadong kaaya-aya. Ganun ang lens. Okay. So, isa sa mga lens defects na tinutukoy natin is what we call aberration. It is the failure of light rays to focus properly after they pass through a lens or reflect from a mirror. So, kung maalala nyo yung discussions natin dati, nag-focus ang lente or ang light rays kapag nagtagpo sila sa isang point. Yun yung focal point. Sa aberration, hindi sila nagtatagpo. Kaya hindi na focus. So proper focus occurs when the light rays cross one another at a single point. Yun nga yung tinatawag natin na focal point. Aberration occurs because of minute, very small variations in lenses and mirrors, and because different parts of the light spectrum are reflected or refracted by varying amounts. Aberration, also defined as optical imperfection, is responsible for image distortion. Kapag distorted ang image, merong aberration. It can be avoided by combining several lenses and by elimination of marginal rays refracted through the outer edges of the lens. Sabi nga natin kanina, walang isang lente na perfect. Walang isang lente na taglay niya lahat. At para maging close to perfect ang isang lente, kailangan dagdagan mo pa siya ng ibang lens. Papatungan mo pa siya ng ibang lens. Okay. Para magtagpo sila in the middle, magkaroon ng compromise, maging mas maganda yung image na makukuha natin. Lenses or mirrors that are sections of spheres produce spherical aberrations. If a beam of parallel rays reflects from a concave mirror, then the rays that reflects from the center of the mirror cross one another at a single point. The rays that reflects far from the center cross at points closer to the mirror surface. The imaginary line connecting these points of focus is called caustic. Ito yon, yung imaginary lines na pupunta doon sa ating focal point. We call that caustic. A caustic appears as a bright line if it shines on a surface. So here are the types of optical aberration. Spherical aberration, nagkaroon na tayong konting idea kanina. Chromatic aberration, astigmatism, coma, curvature of field, and distortion. Okay, so spherical aberration muna. Aberration has geometrical optics predicts that rays of light emanating from a point are imaged by spherical optical elements as a small blur. Ganun siya magta-translate sa ating image, small blur. The outer parts of a spherical surface have a focal length different from that of the central area. If you can remember, pag sinabi natin focal length, this is the distance between your focal point and the center or your image sensor. Yung layo nila, that is your focal length. Posible ba na magkaroon ng madaming focal length? Posible kapag may ganito, kapag may aberration nga. Okay. So, and this defect causes a point to be imaged as a small circle. The difference in focal length of the various parts of the spherical section is called spherical aberration. So this is found in all lenses bounded by spherical aberration or surfaces. The marginal portions of the lens bring rays of light to shorter focus than the central region. The image of a point in space is therefore not a point but a blur circle. Ayun, ito ang makikita ng viewer. Circle na blurred. Okay. So spherical aberration is the focusing at the different parts of spherical lenses. 'Di ba? Sabi nga natin, para maging focus ang isang image, kailangan magtagpo yung light rays sa isang point. Yun yung focal point. Kaso sa spherical aberration, madami tayong focal length. Again, focal length is the distance between the image sensor and the focal point. Dahil madami nga at hindi nagtatagpo sa isang point, kaya madami tayo focal length. Kaya ang translation nga niya sa image is blurred, katulad nitong mga nakikita niyong pictures. This aberration occurs because light hitting the outer parts of the lens is bent more sharply and comes to a focus sooner than that passing through the middle. In spherical aberration, the image is blurred because different parts of a spherical lens or mirror have different focal lengths. Another aberration is chromatic aberration. All lenses made of one material refract rays of short wavelength more strongly than those of longer wavelength and so brings blue more to a shorter focus than red. Mas nagiging malapit ang blue, mas nagfo-focus ang blue sa mas malapit kaysa sa red. The result is that the image of a point white light is not a white point, but a blur circle bordered with colors. Katulad nito. A chromatic aberration is the failure of different colored light rays to focus after passing through a lens, focusing of light of different colors at different points, resulting in a blurred image. When white light, which consists of colors, passes through a lens, the lens bend the rays. The rays then cross one another on the other side. If you can remember yung lesson natin sa colors, di ba? The combination of all colors is equals to white. The presence of all colors is white. Ngayon, kapag yung white light ay pumapasok sa lens, nagbe-bend yun. Kapag nagbe-bend, naghihiwalay yung mga kulay. Okay. Anong nangyayari sa image? Kung mapapansin nyo dito, may violet sa gilid. Yan yun. Tapos dito, very prominent itong color na cyan dito sa branch na ito. Ganun din dito, kita yung mga violet. Yan ang chromatic aberration. Unlike here, wala na yung mga yon dahil corrected na ito. Okay. Ito rin. The violet rays bend more than the other colors and focus close to the lens. Kaya mas prominent yung mga violet na shade. The red rays bend the least and focus farther from the lens. Rays on the other colors focus at points between these two points. Kaya dito, may chromatic aberration. Sabi nga, mas nagbe-bend ang color violet. And if you can also remember our topic before, the color violet is the color that is bent the most. Bent the least naman ang red. Eto, balik tayo sa picture. Kung nakikita nyo ito, may violet dito sa likuran niya. But dito, wala na. Dahil na-correct na. Ayun. Chromatic aberration. In chromatic aberration, the image is surrounded by colored fringes because light at different colors is brought to different focal points by a lens. Chromatic aberration is the inability of a lens to bring the different wavelengths of white light to a focus on the same plane. Ayan, kaya kita na may ibang colors dyan. Because of the index of refraction varies with wavelength, the focal length of a lens also varies and causes longitudinal or axial chromatic aberration. Each wavelength forms an image of a slightly different size, giving rise to what is known as lateral chromatic aberration. Ito pa, iba nating examples. So combinations of converging and diverging lenses and of components made of glasses with different dispersions help to minimize chromatic aberration. Mirrors are free of this defect. In general, achromatic lens combinations are corrected for chromatic aberration for two or three colors. Okay. Next is astigmatism. Ako, may astigmatism ako. So astigmatism is the defect in which the light coming from an off-axis object point is spread along the direction of the optic axis. If the object is a vertical line, the cross-section of the refracted beam at successively greater distances from the lens is an ellipse that collapses first into a horizontal line. It spreads out again and later becomes a vertical line. Ganito. Ang itsura niya. So astigmatism is the failure of a lens to produce a point image of an object point. Such condition occurs when the lens surfaces are not symmetrical with respect to the principal axis of the plane. Kapag hindi daw siya symmetrical dito, itong color green na line na ito, itong mga dash. An extreme example would be one surface is spherical and the other is cylindrical. Or when the lens surfaces are perfectly spherical but the beam of light from the object point passes through the lens very obliquely. So in astigmatism, the image appears elliptical or cross-shaped because of an irregularity in the curvature of the lens. This is the inability of the lens to bring horizontal and vertical lines in the subject to the same plane focus in the image. Ayun, hindi nga nagtatagpo yung mga linya na nandyan, yung horizontal and vertical lines. So, it is the inability of the lens to produce a sharply focused image of both vertical and horizontal lines upon the same plane at one lens to produce a sharp image. Ito. Kung may astigmatism ka, ganito ang nakikita mo. Parang nagdodoble yung mga bagay-bagay na nakikita mo. Para siyang may shadow. Unlike kapag wala namang astigmatism, ganito. This image may be in a camera, pero sa tao, ganyan din. Dahil ganyan din ang nakikita ko. Okay. Next is coma. So the result in differences in lateral magnification for rays coming from an object point not on the optical axis is an effect called coma. So if a coma is present, light from a point is spread out into a family of circles that form into a cone. Kumbaga, yung isang bilog, dumami siya. Paulit-ulit. Kaya ang naging itsura niya, para na siyang cone, katulad nito. So, the image pattern is comet-shaped. Coma may be eliminated for a single object image point pair, but not for all such points by a suitable choice of surfaces. Coma is a pear-shaped image of small circle or point near the edges of the image plane. Katulad nito. Ito yung pinaka-light source, di ba? Tapos mag-e-extend siya. Dahil nga yung bilog, yung tinutukoy niyang circle, ay mag re-reproduce and then para na siyang cone. So ayan, yung mga extended na light na yan. That is coma. The result of which is an overall spot that is comatic in shape, having bright central core, bright yung nasa gitna, eto, with a flare extending towards the optical axis of the lens, katulad ng mga ito. Yan yung coma. Coma occurs when light falling obliquely on the lens and passing through different circular zones is brought to a focus at different distances from the plane film. A spot of light appears to have a tail rather than a comet. In coma, the images appear progressively elongated toward the edge of the field of view. Ayan, it is elongated. The term coma was coined in 1733 by French mathematician Alexis Clairaut. Next is curvature of field, a curved, concave, or saucer-shaped image of an object which has a flat surface produced by simple lens. So, anong itsura niya? In curvature aberration, the relation of the images of the different points are incorrect with respect to one another. In curvature, the images of the different points of the plane image lie on a curved surface with points at the edge of the field lying nearer to the lens than those at the center. In curvature, the images' distance is different for different points of the same object due to their differing distance from the axis. So, may parts na mukhang malapit, may parts na mukhang malayo yung mga subject mo. The fuzziness increases towards the edge of the film. Kaya dito, fuzzy siya, pero dito focused. Refocusing brings different circle into focus but others are now blurred. So, etong nasa harap ay focus. Then, the background is fuzzy. Kapag nirefocus mo siya, pwedeng dito naman yung focus, tapos dito naman yung blurred sa other side. Okay. Next is distortion. Distortion arises from a variation of magnification with actual distance and is not caused by a lack of sharpness in the image. So, meron tayong barrel distortion and pincushion distortion. Ganyan. Pansinin nyo itong mga linya. Pag barrel distortion, napupunta siya sa side. Diba? Kumbaga, nag-enlarge sa middle. Pag pincushion naman, paloob yung linya, diba? So, nag-fit siya. Pag-anon. Okay. When there exists a different magnification for rays at different angles, distortion exists. Any straight light extending across the field is considered curved, and for different lenses, the curvature may be from or toward the center. The distortion is called barrel distortion in the first case, and it is the common type of curvilinear defect. The second distortion is the pincushion effect. So, literal na parang pincushion. Alam niyo yung pinang, kung saan nagtutusok ng pin kapag nananahi. Diba? Parang pillow yun. Yan, pincushion. Kapag barrel naman, pataba siya. Ayan. So, for correction of two similar lenses, each of half necessary power are placed a short distance apart with a diaphragm between. Such lens is called rectilinear lens. So, katulad nito, ito ang original. Pag barrel, na-enlarge nga siya sa gitna. Pag pincushion naman, napupush siya sa gitna. Paloob naman ang itsura ng picture. Okay? So, other optical defects. These defects are usually corrected when the lens is designed. However, they can occur if the lens is misused or through normal wear. Ito yung mga iba pang optical defects. Flare or optical flare, mechanical flare, light loss, and stray light. Ano ba yung flare? These defects are usually corrected when the lens is designed. However, they can occur if the lens is misused or through normal wear. Sorry. Okay, so ito yung flare. Flare is a non-image forming light. This reduces contrast and color saturation. Flare is caused by very bright subject areas and produces internal reflections in the lens. Stacking of lens of filters can increase flare. Lens coatings by the manufacturer keeps flare to a minimum. The use of a suitable hood can also aid in reducing flare. Ito yon yung flare. Remember coma? Sabihin na natin medyo parehas sila, but ang nangyayari kasi sa flare ay yung reflection mula doon sa subject mo ay, sorry, di ba may light na nanggagaling sa subject mo. And then, nagkakaroon ng reflection doon din sa loob ng lens. Kaya kapag nagpicture ka, may nakukuha kang ganito, flare. Ayan. So, light that doesn't belong in an image, often taking the shape of the aperture, generally caused by shooting towards the light source. The source may appear in the image as a reflection from the interior of the camera or from the lens. Flare often results in an overall reduction of image contrast. Okay, so kung mapapansin ninyo dito, medyo ka-shape niya yung ating aperture. Kasi nga, di ba, nagre-reflect lang siya sa loob. So, ito, shape yan ang aperture. Yan yung flare. Okay? Flare can show up as a plain area of unwanted bright light or in shapes matching the aperture. Katulad din nito. Yan, di ba? Ka-shape siya ng aperture. Or ganito. Yan, di ba? Para may alien na kukuha sa'yo. Yan, unwanted light. Okay. So, next is mechanical flare. These are bright spots on the film caused by stray light from worn shiny parts of the lens such as the stop, shutter lens, mount, or from the camera itself. Next is light loss. Most covered lenses is coated with a substance which will reduce one type of flare and which will also increase the optic's ability to transmit light, thus reducing light loss. And then stray light, this can be reduced or eliminated by using the proper lens shade placed on the front of the lens as shield.